Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss one very interesting problem taken from LeetCode, and the problem is create target array in the given order. Okay, that means you will be given one order, you will be given some elements to be inserted in the array, you have to create your target array according to that order. So the problem says, given two arrays of integer nums and index, your task is to create target array under the following rules. Initially target array is empty. From left to right, read nums of I and index of I. You are given two array, right? Nums and index, those two you have to read from the left. Insert at index of I, the value nums of I in the target array. That means at index I, we have to insert the value nums I, okay? Repeat the previous step until there is no element to read in nums and index. Return the target array. It is guaranteed that insertion operation will be valid. That means there will be no such index in the index array like -1, -2, which are invalid. We don't need to think about those. So if you go to example test case, you can understand the problem more easily. Suppose our nums array is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and the index array is 0, 1, 2, 2, 1. Our output array should be 0, 4, 1, 3, 2. Why? See, start traversing from left to right in both the nums and index array. First, at index array, you are getting 0 index. So in your target array, in the 0th index, insert the 0 value. So our target array is 0. Then at index 1, insert the 1 value. So our array is 0, 1. At index 2, insert the 2 value. Our array is 0, 1, 2. At index 2, again we have to insert 3 value. So our new array will be 0, 1, 3, 2. See, at index 2, when we are inserting 3, this 2 which was present at index 2 is shifted to the right hand side. This is what has to be done in the programming. And at index 1, we have to insert 4. So when we are inserting at index 4, at index 1, the value 4, the rest of the element 1, 3, 2 is shifted to the right hand side. So our output array is 0, 4, 1, 3, 2. If you take the example 2, see, nums equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 0 and index equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 0. So start traversing from left to right in both the array. At index 0, 1 has to be inserted, target array become 1. At index 1, 2 has to be inserted, target array become 1, 2. At index 2, 3 has to be inserted, target array is 1, 2, 3. At index 3, 4 has to be inserted, target array is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now at index 0, we are inserting the value 0. That means at the beginning, we have to insert 0. So output array is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Consider the test case 3. Nums equal to 1, index equal to 0. Simple, in the target array, just at 0th index, we have to give 1. And that's all. No other element to further, no need to read. So output is 1. Constant is given as nums.length, index.length is ranging from 1 to 100. Nums.length equal to index.length. And nums of I, that is a particular element is ranging in the nums array ranging from 0 to 100 and a particular element in the index array is ranging from 0 to I. Try to think about one algorithm which can be used to solve this particular problem. Implement that. Check whether it is giving correct output or not. If it is not giving correct output, no need to worry, here I am explaining. So see, we have to insert in a particular position. Suppose already any element is present in that index, then we have to shift. So the easiest way to do this kind of inserting a particular element in a particular position is using ArrayList. So we will use ArrayList to store in a particular index and then we will create the output array using the ArrayList. That's what I have written here. Class solution, solution is our class name. Public int, return type is integer array. Create target array, this is our function name. Int array nums, int array index, two array nums and index we are passing through our function create target array. Then we are creating one array list to do this kind of insertion. Then we are traversing from left to right. For int I equal to 0, I less than nums.length I plus plus. You can use for int I equal to 0, I less than index.length I plus plus also because nums and index having same length. What we have to do? A.add index of I, nums of I. That is at that index we have to put that particular nums of I. Now we are creating one output array of same length as of our array list. And then or as same length as our nums array or index array, and then traverse from beginning to the end of the array list, put that element in the output array. So for int I equal to 0, I less than nums dot length I plus plus output of I equal to a dot get I, return the output. That's all. So here in solving this particular problem, collection is helping us. So if you are doing programming in Java, then having a good clear concept in collection is very important and very helpful for placement process. Here you can see the acceptance status. Runtime is 0 millisecond, 100% efficient. Memory usage is also 100% efficient, 38.2 MB. So this type of problems, try to practice from LeetCode. This will surely help you for placement preparation. I am going to post same code in the comment section of this video. If you want, you can check there. Thank you.